What's your name?
Sharkel.
Sister Sharkel, all right. I see you've been up here for a little minute, right?
Yeah.
So let me ask you something. What have you learned today? Okay. The commandments, right? Okay. You part of what? So you know that you're what? You know that you're an Israelite according to the Bible, right? So give me Isaiah chapter 29, verse 13. Let me ask you a question, sis. So with you learning that the seventh day is the Sabbath day, right? Which is what day? A Saturday, right? What day were we taught that, what? Who taught us that, sis? Where did we learn that? We learned it in church, right? But what does the Bible say that the Sabbath day is? Which means that the Christian church is a what? It's a lie. Exactly. Read what you got.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 29 and verse 13.
Read.
Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me with me.
So it says the Lord said that these people, they draw near to me, right? Who is these people talking about? Your Christian pastors. They get in there shucking and jiving. Hey, hallelujah. Praise Jesus Christ, right? But they're not keeping nothing that this Bible says to keep. Read.
With their mouth and with their lips do honor me.
So they honor Jesus with their lips. They honor God. Oh, all praises to the Lord. Give glory to the Father. Right? Read.
But I removed their heart far from me.
But it says that their hearts are not with him. Do you understand that? So what does that mean? That means that they're not teaching you properly according to what the Bible actually says. Read.
And their fear towards me is taught by the precept of men.
By what?
The precept of men.
So, what man taught us that the church, we're supposed to keep the Sabbath on a Sunday? Who taught us that? And who taught him that?
Break it out.
The same people that gave us this man to worship as a god. The so-called white man. He gave us that in slavery, right? Of course he did. That's all he speaks is lies. Actually, give me that. That's all he speaks is lies. He came out the womb speaking lies. What's that? Get that. So, listen. This man from the womb, he has spoke lies to us. When we came over on those slave ships, because you know we came over on slave ships, right? Did you know that that's actually documented in the Bible? Okay, and we're gonna show you some more on that, all right? Read what you got.
The book of Psalms, chapter 58 and verse 3.
Read.
The wicked are estranged from the womb.
The wicked are estranged from the womb. Who is the wicked? We're going to help you out. You ain't got to answer. We're going to answer it for you. It's the so-called white man today. Read.
They go astray as soon as they be born.
So as soon as they're born, read.
Speaking lies.
Speaking what?
Speaking lies.
So when they come out the womb and they, even that's a lie. They cries are lies. Everything about these people are lies. They're lies. Give me Job chapter 9 and verse 24. Watch this, sis. We want to furthermore touch on who this wicked is for you real quick. Watch this. Read what you got.
The book of Job chapter 9 is verse 4.
24.
Excuse me. Verse 24, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked.
So we live on planet earth today, right?
Yep.
It said that the earth is what?
Given into the hand of the wicked.
Who's running the earth today, sis? Who's on top today?
No.
Don't be scared to say it. I want you to say it. Far too long, we've been afraid to speak the truth.
Bring it on.
I want you to tell us who the wicked man is. The white man, exactly. You don't have to be scared to say that, sis. You don't have to be scared to say that. They not scared to stereotype you, right? They'll do it in a heartbeat, right? Niggas, they love to eat chicken and watermelon, right? They not scared to say it about you.
Yeah, you're right.
So we gonna speak the truth around here, all right? Read it one more time. What's your name, sister? I see that you're paying attention. How you doing?
Hi, I'm TT.
You TT. Nice to meet you, sister TT. I'm Eli, by the way. Nice to meet y'all. Read that again.
Verse 24, the earth is given unto the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof.
So, when you know who the wicked is, right, and that it was given into his hands, then you understand where everything else starts to come from. So all of these lies that we've been taught, that Jesus Christ looks like this man, right? We learned that it's a lie.
Yeah.
Because Whose image was he made after? The white man. Does the Bible support that?
Yes.
It does. So where does it support that? Where does it say that Jesus Christ looks like that man? It don't say that, right? So do y'all know where to find how Jesus Christ actually looks? You hitting on something, my sister. You hitting on something. Give me that. Revelation. Read that. Start at verse 1.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 1.
First, give me John chapter 7. I gotta show y'all something real quick, all right? Because this is important that we have to understand exactly what Christ looks like, and we have to believe on him the same way, right? Give me John chapter 7, verse 38.
The book of John, chapter 7 and verse 38. And he believeth on me, as the scripture has said. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said.
So he that believes on me, as the scripture says, right, Greek?
Out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water.
You will have the understanding of what this Bible is actually talking about, because you will know what Jesus Christ actually looks like. So why is it that they gave us this man to worship? Wow. I'll tell you why, my sister, because you're not going to get these S's in the Christian church.
Right.
They want you. The whole purpose, right, is for them to keep the dominion on the face of this planet. If you believe on this Jesus Christ and not what Christ actually looks like, you will have no understanding. So guess what? The white man, he can walk all through your hoods, right, and not be touched. He can go through the Crip neighborhoods and have on all red. He can go through blood neighborhoods and have on all blue and won't nothing happen to him, right? But your brother go through that. Hey, nigga, where you from? What hood you claim? Where your grandma stay, right? Why is that? That's because they don't know that God looks just like them. He looked like you. He looked like me, right? We're going to get some characteristics of what this Jesus Christ really looked like. Read what you got.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 1.
Read.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
So this is the revelation. What does revelation mean? It's in the word. It means to reveal. That's all. It means to reveal, right? Read.
Which God gave unto them to show unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass.
So, John the Revelator, he's about to reveal something to us. He's going to tell us what Jesus Christ actually looks like, right? Jump down to verse 14.
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Well, what?
Were white like wool.
So it said his head and his hairs were white like wool. Who on the face of the planet has woolly hair? We do, right?
Right.
So who did the Bible just said had woolly hair? God. Jesus Christ, the black Messiah. Read.
As white as snow, and his eyes was a flame of fire.
So it said that his eyes was a flame of fire. Why would his eyes be a flame of fire? What was the first miracle that Jesus Christ did? He turned water into wine. He was a wine drinker. He drank in moderation, right? So it's okay to drink in moderation as long as you ain't getting drunk. Jesus Christ was that example. Read.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
Now we're really about to get into it. It said that his feet were as fine brass. Now see, you got slides on, you got socks covering it up, right? But let me ask you a question. It said that his feet were as fine brass. The top of your feet, is it any different color from the rest of your body? What about you, sis?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, what? Okay, well, it's a little light, right, because you cover it up, right?
Yeah.
But it said that his feet were like fine brass, right? So ultimately, your feet are brown, correct?
Right.
Just like the rest of your body, right? Read.
As if they burn in a furnace.
So it said that Jesus Christ had feet like polished brass, as if it burned in a furnace.
Right.
If you burn anything, what color does it be? Is black. So what color is Jesus Christ? So why in the world are we worshiping this man? Why? Who gave us this image? The so-called white man. But God says that he's a black man with woolly hair. You got to learn to love yourself. Because if you worship that man, you definitely have no love for yourself.
Shalom, Israel. This is Bishop Nathaniel. I want you to know that you can view all our Sabbath classes live on IUIC TV. That's right. I said on IUIC TV. Download the app today. Shalom.
What is your nationality? Because now you're finding out that Jesus Christ is a black man, so you said you're black. So go back to the land of black. Where will we find that at? Right, because it's no such thing. That was something that they gave to us. You see what I'm saying? We're going to call you Negroes. We're going to call you blacks, African Americans. How can you be an African American? Are you from Africa? Is it America? No, that name actually came from two white men. Leo Scipios Africanus and what was the Amerigo Vespucci, right? Two white men. Now, can you put two white men together and get a black child?
No,
you can't even put, it don't make sense. It don't make sense. So why did they give us African American as a nationality? Because they don't want us to know where we actually come from. If we know who we are, where we came from, and who our God is, guess what? This thing is over. We getting out of here. Jesus Christ, he's going to fight for us like the brother was telling you earlier, right? He showed you who also came from that tribe, right? So what would your father be, a so-called African-American? My sister, come here. I want you to look at this sign. Come a little bit closer. All right. Where do you see yourself on this sign? What would your father be considered? How you doing, my sister? I want you to take a look at this sign. I want you to find yourself. Black Americans, all right? I want you to find yourself on this sign. So we teaching our people our true heritage according to the Bible. Where do you see yourself? So you said African-American or so-called black Americans, right? But God says that you come from the tribe of Judah.
Right.
You say the tribe of Judah. So let me show you what's special about that tribe. How you doing, my brother? Come on over. You can listen too. Give me that Hebrews chapter 7 and verse 14. We want to show you. Oh, okay. You know speak English? All right, I got you, bro. All right, Hebrews chapter 7, verse 14.
The book of Hebrews.
You where? You from the tribe of... That is a mighty tribe. Did you know that Paul, the person that wrote the majority of the New Testament, is also from the tribe of Benjamin, a black man? Did you know that? These are righteous men. Our forefathers are the prophets of old. We are back today to teach our people the truth according to what thus saith the Lord. Right? Read what you got.
The book of Hebrews, chapter 7 and verse 14. For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, which...
Read it again. I'm sorry. Read it again.
For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah.
So who is our Lord? No, who is our Lord? Who is our Lord that sits...
God.
Right. Jesus Christ. Right? It said that he came out of where? Where did he come from? Y'all listening to me? Y'all paying attention, Sister TT? You listening? Where is our Lord? Where did it say that our Lord sprang out of? Read it again.
For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah.
Out of where?
Out of Judah.
Out of where?
Out of Judah.
So where did our Lord come from? He came from Judah. Okay, that's what I'm saying. I got to make sure that y'all paying attention, that y'all following along. Right. So it said that he came out of Judah, right? So that would mean that he would look just like you and me, right? So why is it important for us to understand that? If our God looks just like us, why are we living in these conditions? Give me that in Deuteronomy, chapter 28. Why are we living in these conditions? Okay, yeah, we've been lied to, but we holding on to lies, right? Right. It also gets a little bit deeper than that. So because we broke God's law, statutes, and commandments, which you get, matter of fact, give me Deuteronomy 11 and verse 26. We broke God's law, statutes, and commandments, which is why we're in this estate that we're in today. All right? So, do y'all know y'all's nationality? Y'all know that y'all are Israelites from the tribe of Judah, right? My sister says she's from the tribe of Benjamin. These are the 12 tribes of Israel. So God gave specific law, statutes, and commandments, Deuteronomy 7 and 6. He gave specific law, statutes, and commandments to these nations of people. The so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans for us to keep, right? Read what you got.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7 and verse 6.
Read.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
So he says that we are holy, meaning separate to the Lord our God, right? He's making it personal, right? Read.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
Let me ask y'all a question. Any one of y'all married? Am I married? Okay. Well, the scripture said that he said that we are a special people to him. Now, let me ask you this. Y'all have husbands, right, that come to you say that say, baby, you so special to me. I choose you above all these women, right? I don't want nobody else on the face of this planet, just you, right? How would that make you feel? It'd make you feel real special, right? How much more special should you feel knowing that God says that about you?
Yes, right.
How much more special should you feel? The creator of the heavens and the earth and all things in it.
Right.
He said that you're special to me. You people, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Right.
He said, you're separate. You're holy. Is there more on that? Read on.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
It says that we are above all people on the face of the earth. We read earlier that the earth was given into the hand of the wicked. So how is it that they're above us? Hold on, my sister, don't go nowhere. You got to go to, we got some more for you though. Oh, see, that's how it works. See, one leave and everybody else got to go. See, okay, look, listen, sis. I want you to look at that flyer, all right? Call us, okay? Call us. What's your nationality, sis? Judah.
Wow.
You're an Israelite according to the Bible, my sister.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.